You'll sell me their services. No questions asked on my part.
Oh, maybe it's not this way. Oh. Oh. Nope. There's nothing back here. Doesn't seem like it anyway. Okay. Oh! Are these special people? Ah, it seems like I can see certain people through the walls. There's a lot of people of interest here, holy crap! All of these people have names! Oh my god, I really don't- Who are these people? Okay, well my goal is to get over to this person. Idaba. Oh my goodness. We gotta make sure to talk to all these people.
Preferably with no friends or family, but I'm not choosy.
Now you know why he doesn't want anyone with a family. Nothing to... No one to complain to him about people missing.
We've lived under the same sun all this time. Imagine.
Ooh, is that very hard to imagine?
You need to win 3 half suns at our hunting grounds to gain admittance to the lodge.
You mean these?
Very well then. Congratulations. And welcome. Our members reap rewards and adventure and live on in legend.
Am I a member now?
No, you're only a fledgling. Junior members are called thrushes. To join and become a thrush, you need a senior member called a hawk to sponsor you.
So I need to find a hawk?
Yes, but a hawk can only sponsor one hunter at a time. And I'm afraid most of them already have one.
I've overcome worse odds. Where do I start?
Upstairs. Present yourself to the Sun Hawk Assis, our leader, who should introduce you to a hawk. I hope it's worth it.
What do you mean?
You'll see.
I love this bit.
Hey! This guy's makeup! Like the eye, the little circle in the line. That's exactly the same as Nil's makeup. Oh, this person too, their dress. Nil! Nil might be a hunter. Or an ex-hunter. Oh. Hello.
By the sun, King Avad's edict really is taking effect. Never thought I'd see a Nora here and a woman at that. So, you have marks for me?
What do you mean?
From the hunting grounds. Oh, right. You're new here.
Edict.
What edict?
King Avad insisted that the Hunter's Lodge had to welcome everyone. Man, woman, outlander, regardless of tribe. Ursa, captain of the vanguard, came in and delivered that news personally.
Oh.
You should have been there. It was glorious. But I figured they would sweep it under the rug and say no woman or outlander qualified. Yet here you are.
But she's dead. Like, the Sun King seems like he's doing a lot of good things on the surface, but even if he says, hey guys, get along, it doesn't mean the people he orders around are gonna listen to him. Oh, that's why the Karjans are kind of like tribist.
Are you a member?
Me? No. Karja don't exactly encourage their daughters to run around hunting machines. But all the changes in Meridian have been good to me. I don't think the Asaram know how to sell to us Karja. The trader I worked for last couldn't sell flowers to a bee. He was too plain hammered, as they like to say. This is a much better job. I figure I'll be able to open my own shop soon enough.
Cool.
What do you want with my marks?
You hunters and your badges. I'm not gonna take them. I'm going to give you a weapon that sets you apart.
Ooh.
Yeah, I thought that'd get your attention. If you earn marks in all 3 trials at each of the 5 hunting grounds, come to me.
Hey, we got...
I can give you up to 3 weapons. 1 for 15 half-suns, 1 for 15 full-suns, and 1 you'll love for all blazing suns.
Oh, but I've only cleared 2 hunting grounds so far, so I don't have 15 marks.
What do I do with these marks?
If you get the same mark from all the hunting ground trials, I can give you a Hunter's Lodge weapon. Show me what marks you've earned, and we'll see if you qualify for one of these special weapons I have for you.
I'm a little short on marks.
No problem. Once you have marks from all 15 trials, you'll be able to get the next Hunter's Lodge weapon from me.
God damn it.
Oh, you're in for a treat.
They're giving me an incentive to go back to those stupid hunting grounds. Ah! Just thinking about the... What was it? The Val... No, not the Valley Meat. The Great Run one is hurting my head. Bylaws of the Lodge. Section 1, Preamble. The hunt is the noblest pursuit in the Sundom, save those of the Sun King and his Sun Priests. The hunt is strength. The hunt is honor. The hunt protects. The hunt preserves. 1.2. What is the hunt but competition? What is competition without rank, honor, and victor? Are these like the rules? The Lodge lends laws and lore to the hunt, so all will know who has prevailed. It's all about achievements and accomplishments. Thus the Lodge is not just its members, not just its house in Meridian, it is a spirit of the hunt, a code to be honored, an ideal to be lived. Only those of the noblest blood can embody the noblest ideals. Whoa! As such, only Karja males of pure blood may honor the Lodge and tread in its house. Oh, but 1.6. By order of his radiance, Avad, 14th Sun King of the Karja, Bylaw 5 of Section 1 is hereby rescinded. They don't erase it though, they, I don't know. They still keep record of it. Okay, how do we gain membership? We know this already. There's two classes of member, Hawk and Thrush. Wait, the rank of Thrush can only be gained through the sponsorship of a Hawk. Each Hawk can only have one Thrush. There can only be 7 Hawks. What? So there can only be 7 Thrushes then? What? But there's like 20 people in here! All fledglings? The hawk who hunts the greatest prey shall become Sunhawk and lead the Lodge. Sunhawk? Could Nil be someone like that? Oh my god. In the event the quality of prey is in dispute, the hawk who hunts it first shall remain first a Sunhawk. Only Karja males of pure blood may become Thrush, Hawk, or Sunhawk. Oh, but it's rescinded again. Proof of hunt. A trophy. Has to be submitted. Must be intact, undamaged, and from a recent hunt. The Sunhawk has final authority over any dispute over a trophy's worth. Rescinded, the thing about Karja males again. So the Hunter's Lodge, in addition to doing this recreationally, they also do it to protect people in the Sundom. Yep. The Sunhawk has sole authority to negotiate any fees or bounties associated with any hunt undertaken by members of the Lodge on behalf of the Sundom. Any profit shall be shared by all 7 Hawks. Oh. What? Wait. So we don't- Okay, the underling members don't get anything then. The Hawks get everything. Rescinded. The Lodge provides hunting grounds. There's 3 rewards for every trial. Half Sun, Full Sun, Blazing Sun. The Lodge provides funds for the construction of and maintenance of all trials and facilities. But the Lodge also receives all profits associated with the sale of parts, ammunition, and equipment from all hunting grounds. So I've given them a lot of money already. To the 7 Hawks. Ah. Interesting. Hey, we can actually go behind the counter. Rude. Yeah, look around. There is way more than just 14 people in here, right? Oh, a lot of these people have names, though.
Tarka's impressed with his skills, but he spotted Talana. Now we're left with her. She had fallen instead.
Whoa! Hey, there's another woman. Alright.
You wouldn't be so eager to speak with me if you knew me.
Ooh, are you a tough guy?
Thinking about heading back to the claim.
Is that where the Ozurum came from? The claim? Hey, you look exactly like that guy.
I've seen that.
I'm a member. Go bother the other sludges and leave me alone.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Oh, all of these people are... Oh, this is the woman! But I can't talk to her. I can't find the spot to talk to her.
Can't believe Redmaw defeated Tarkus. He was such a good hunter, but Redmaw is a beast of a Thunderjaw. I'd never face it.
Redmaw? Hey, Thunderjaw, you know who else beat a Thunderjaw around here? Well, not me, because some dirty car just stole my kill. Huh. I hold grudges. Okay, this lady here, I want to talk to her, but it seems like I can't.
I'm a member.
Yeah.
Go bother the other sludges and leave me alone.
Is that the guy that's sponsoring her? If I check back with this guy.
Tarkus impressed with his skills, but he sponsored Talana. Now we're left with her. She had fallen instead.
Wait, Tarkus is the person who died to the Red Maw.
Can't believe Red Maw defeated Tarkus. He was such a good hunter, but Red Maw is a beast of a Thunderjaw. I'd never face it.
The thing we read earlier mentioned this, but does the thrush become the new hawk? Immediately? After the original hawk dies? Oops. A thrush can only become a hawk through the death of his sponsor. They're not very happy about having a female hawk, though. At least that guy wasn't.
May the sun light your way.
Thank you.
Typical savage. Barging in here without a thought. Right after one of her own was killed. Go away.
You're talking about Ursa, right?
What have we here? Honora Fledge.
I bet I've been hunting longer than you have. Are you a fledgling?
Not for long. I have a hawk who's about to sponsor me, so you're out of luck.
This is someone from Banur. I thought it was a guy outside for a second, because they look really similar. Alright. Just got that guy over here. Who is of interest? You two? Ooh, another female.
I'd asked Talana to sponsor me, but her sponsor just died. I can't imagine what she must be going through.
I've been trophy hunting for years. Still haven't gotten a sponsor.
Since Talana is a female, I don't know. Maybe she's more inclined to sponsor another female. Yeah. You know, like the one that I'm playing as. I didn't even see this here. What the heck is this? What kind of this must be like the biggest trophy they've ever had. Holy crap. They were doing some serious hunting here. Record of Red Maw, the Thunderjaw. By inquiring Gendineman, historian in residence at the Hunter's Lodge. It is well known that facts recede into fictions as they become memories, and fresh facts themselves are ephemeral among the rumors and legends of the South. This is especially true in the case of Red Maw, the most terrible of Thunderjaws, a machine which is nothing if not legendary. Few who have laid eyes upon it have survived, and among them, even fewer can be trusted to not embellish their tales. All that said, here I have endeavored to truthfully chronicle all the calamities attributed to the beast, and all the expeditions meant to end such calamities once and for all. None have succeeded. As of this writing, the terror of the South still roams free, scarred perhaps, but deadly, as the day the sun first shone upon its armored hide. In the early spring of the 18th year of the reign of the Sun King Jiran, is that the 13th one? A freehold was destroyed near the hands of the Flood. 9 bodies were recovered, 8 riddled with cannon rounds, 1 flattened completely. No witnesses survived. Though never proven, this is widely thought to be Red Maw's first attack. In the late spring of the 18th year of the reign of the Sun King Jiran, an expedition of 4 hunters set out from Sunstone Rock to track the machine or machines responsible for the destruction of the freehold. None returned. Their bodies were subsequently found in the south, 3 blasted, 1 stomped. Never proven, but thought to be Red Maw's work. In the early summer of the 18th year of the reign of the Sun King Jiran, an expedition of 6 mercenaries set out from the Meridian to track the machine or machines responsible for the losses described above. One returned, ribs crushed, clavicle fractured. He spoke of a Thunderjaw, which split a man in half with a single bite. This is the first confirmed sighting of the legendary machine, and the one which gave it a name. In the late summer of the 18th year of the reign of the Sun King Jiran, an expedition of 8 set out from Meridian to track Redmaw. None returned. 6 bodies were found near Blackwing's snag. 1 blasted, 3 stomped, 2 eviscerated, 1 swallowed his own tongue, evidently in a spasm of terror, suffocating. In the autumn of the 18th year, the Sun King Jiran commanded the Hunter's Lodge to send an expedition south in pursuit of Redmaw. After numerous logistical delays, 3 hawks and their thrushes set out in winter. Only 1 pair returned, reporting the deaths of the others, 2 blasted, 1 stomped, 1 decapitated. The survivors were sacrificed for cowardice, 1 gutted by a sawtooth, the other skewered by kestrels. Kestrels. After the setback, members of the lodge grew wary of pursuing the legendary Thunderjaw. Only after so long, only the proudest hawks even considered it. Aspirants to the lodge, however, foolish in their ambition, eagerly took part in subsequent hunts. In the summer of the 19th year of the reign of the Sun King Jiran, the destruction of a caravan south of the Spurflint, 3 blasted, 2 stomped, 1 immolated, reignited interest in Redmaw. 3 expeditions totaling 15 mercenaries went after the machine, with only 3 survivors, 9 blasted, 3 stomped, 2 eviscerated, 1 liquefied. How many attacks does this guy have? In the 20th year, a cohort of 12 soldiers headed from the Rain Gatherers to the Alight were set upon by the beast. Only 1 survived, 1 blasted, 1 stomped, 10 crushed when their fleeing footsteps triggered an avalanche. In the late spring of the 20th year, 3 cohorts totaling 34 men went in search of Redmaw. Alas, they were ambushed by stalkers and only 4 survived. 24 sniped! 6 exploded. Sniped? Understandably, this ended pursuit of the Redmaw for some time. In the summer of the first year of the reign of the Sun King Avad, a group of 6 Ozurum traders were attacked by the beast. 1 blasted, 3 stomped, 1 spit into a ravine. How do we get such accurate accounts of all these things? The lone survivor petitioned Captain Ursa to send the vanguard after the monster, but the request was denied. However, 3 additional expeditions, comprised of mercenaries and hunters aspiring to the lodge, were subsequently commissioned. Autumn, 7 men, 1 survivor. Winter, 9 men, 2 survivors. Spring, 11 men, 2 survivors. The last known sighting of Redmaw occurred in the spring of the 3rd year of the reign of the Sun King Avad. Tarkus, Hawk of the Lodge, got word of a sighting near Thunderhead and set off to take the beast on his own. On his own! His thrush, Talana, arrived at the scene too late. Just as Tarkus was dying at his wounds, multiple perforations, Talana testified that as Redmaw lumbered off through the trees, she could see the spear of her mentor embedded in its hide. Ooh. While I was reading this, I thought, hey, maybe it's just a legend that's gone. It's become scarier and scarier the more times we tell it. But if we have that many witness accounts, maybe this thing is really that scary. Oh, man. Ooh. What is this? Is it kind of like a memory of all the hunters of the lodge or something like that? Jeez. Whoa, this is oh my god, look at all those waterfalls. Stunning view. Wow. Would be even more beautiful in the morning. Okay. Who are we looking for here again? There are so many names. Yeah, Assis. Okay. I just noticed this. Triangles. Oh. Whoa! You have metal armor!
It's a bit.
Excuse us. Ah. The machine rider graces us with her presence. You're Anora, are you not? A fighter from the Savage Lands.
The Sacred Land, but yes. I fought for everything I got.
Huh. Rude.
Tell me. Do the Nora often wander into other people's homes and do whatever they like?
Of course not.
But that is what you're doing, right now. Stinking up our lodge, pestering your betters.
You're hardly my better. Legan said I had to meet you to become a member.
That would be true if there were any chance of you becoming a member. But you're a savage. and no savage will rise in the ranks of the Hunter's Lodge while I am the Sun Hawk. Now be gone.
No. I was led to believe there are rules here. If they count for nothing, then even your position is meaningless. So quit blustering and tell me. Is there a hawk who is free to sponsor me?
Very well. Talana is free. Wouldn't that be fitting? Trash sponsoring trash. Now get out of my sight.
Oh my god. What is wrong with the people here? Holy crap. Y'all are very hard to handle. And where the heck did you all come from? Oh my gosh. Lounges. Well, that guy's obviously not liking me very much. I wonder if we can convince him to go to an expedition for the Red Maw or something. Legendary Hunts. Legendary Hunts of the Lodge. In the summer of the fourth year of the reign of the Sun King, Marzid, did Farukawa's Sun Hawk of the Lodge behold a herd of grazers so vast that it filled the entire vale below the farback. His bow was a harp that day, strumming the melody of the hunt from noon to twilight. After, one could not walk a single step across the glen without tripping on an antler of the fallen. It took all seven hawks and all seven thrushes to gather the trophies, and with the bounty from their barter, the last wing of the lodge was raised. In the winter of the seventh year of the Sun King Hivas, okay, so these are really far apart, they must be really legendary hunts, did Darusev, Hawk of the Lodge, stalk a herd of tramplers from Sand Whisper Valley to the foothills of the Pale Reach. Bombs from his sling fell as hailstones, freezing his prey in the waters of the ford. While the others stood as statues in ice, Hivas set upon the largest, driving his spear between the plates, taking his trophy before the rest could stir. In the spring of the third year of the reign of the Sun King Geron, as the machines of the wild grew ever more deranged, did Kuvam, Hawk of the Lodge, answer the call from the prefect at Daytower to slay the mysterious creature who ripped his best cohort limb to limb. 4 days and four nights he tracked his quarry through the savage east. There it is again, you guys are rude. Before the brute was revealed, strong as a snapjaw, fast as a strider, from twilight to midnight, the battle raged, but Kuvam prevailed at great cost, his left arm chewed ragged at the joint. Thus, he named the beast Sawtooth as he took his trophy from its shattered remains. Oh! Oh wow, so even the Sawtooth was only defeated not that long ago, during the third year of the Sun King Geron's reign. In the autumn of the eighth year of the reign of the Sun King Geron, as the machines in the wilds grow ever more deranged, did Galadid, Hawk of the Lodge, follow the shimmering death haunting the southern freehold into the jungles of the Jewel. Under the tangled canopy, the hunter became the hunted, glimpsing in the shadows more of the eerie lights, till he was surrounded by machines he named Stalkers. Stalkers! We've only seen that one time so far! Where are they? I completely forgot about them. Long was his flight through the undergrowth to the safety of the alight, but along the way, he turned his bow to his pursuers and became the first to snare a trophy from that which walks in the glinting shadow. In the summer of the 13th year of the reign of the Sun King Geron, as the machines of the wild grow ever more deranged, did Aziz, Hawk of the Lodge, dare to tread the path of broken trees, following the wake of the terrible thing that laid waste to the freehold of morning light. And so he was the first to face the might of the Thunderjaw, greatest of machines that walk the earth. With spear, bomb, and arrow, brave Aziz fought to no avail, and only triumphed by turning the terror's own cannons against it. Wow, that's exactly how I did it too. The carcass of the beast now hangs in the lodge for all to see, so enshrined because its fall turned hawk to sunhawk. Oh. Now I'm starting to wonder in my head, was the guy who stole my Thunderjaw kill Aziz? But I don't remember the Thunderjaw being that big. This seems huge. Wow. Oh my god, you know, that would be so cool if they actually register that I defeated a Thunderjaw before. Even if they do, that's none of my business, because I never killed one. That's fine, that's fine. I'm sure we'll have the opportunity to go up against the Red Maw. Okay. Oh, Talana. Would you like to sponsor a Nora Outlander? Someone you don't know at all? Oh! She's not here anymore!
Ah, waste of time. Show was better
last. Oh, there's so many people here now. What the heck? Hey, where is Talana? Oh, look at that. It shows how many half-sons I have. 6 out of 15. Oh, I feel like I have to do them eventually, because I want those weapons. Yeah. Oh no, but they gave you a freaking war bow, but I don't... I just put the mods on my war bow, didn't I? Oh, hunter bow. Never mind. I'm fine. Where are you?
Other tribes do.
Talana?
Just mind my own.
Wait, up here? Oh, you're right here.
Here, Talana? Bessie said you were a hawk without a fledgling to sponsor. Or are you trying to drive me off too? It's okay, I've dealt with worse.
I'll bet you have. But you're wrong. It's not okay. Especially not today.
Yeah, you're a little rude today because her hawk just died.
What happened today?
One of our own just died fighting Red Maw. You'll never face a more dangerous Thunderjaw. Cuts through trees, rocks, people.
I'm sorry to hear that.
It's part of the hunt.
Assis, what's his story?
He's the Sun Hawk of the Lodge. The highest ranking asshole. Sorry, member. He's taken down ravagers, stalkers, behemoths.
So? I've taken down a lot of machines.
As have I. Even brought down 2 stormbirds.
Whoa.
But he's a hawk who brought in the trophies first. That's how it works. Whichever hawk defeats the greatest machine first becomes a Sun Hawk.
I haven't fought a stormbird before.
How does one become a hawk?
When a hawk dies, his thrush is promoted in his place, no matter how anyone feels about it.
You notice their armor, they're all very, like, hawky. Does that make sense?
Who is this Legan, the man at the door?
Legan? He's a hawk.
Ooh!
He had an impressive run in his day, but he doesn't fight anymore. He supports the lodge in other ways. Unlike the other hawks, who hoard all the best kills and drink the bar dry.
Wait, but once you become a hawk, you can never not become a hawk. So if you stop fighting, then you'll basically be a hawk until the day you die. Hey, that guy's smart.
Is there any actual hunting in this lodge? So far, it's been all talk.
Yes, of course. You fight a machine, then bring its trophy to Assis, the Sunhawk, then no one can deny you brought it down.
The Red Maw.
I'm ready to hunt, so tell me, what do I have to do?
You want them to regret looking down on you? Then speak to them in their language. Kill 3 sawtooths, 2 ravagers, and a stalker. Deliver their trophies directly to Assis. That should shut them all up.
So if I do that, you'll sponsor me?
I'll consider it. Just to make Assis boil.
Oh, this is gonna be a freaking cakewalk. Cakewalk, because... Yeah, that phrase makes no sense. It's like combining a walk in the park with a piece of cake. Anyway, that lady, though. This lady wanted to be sponsored. How is she gonna feel about me?
I'd asked Talana to sponsor me, but her sponsor just died. I can't imagine what she must be going through.
Should've asked, because I'm taking your opportunity. I think that's all for the persons of interest in the lodge, for now anyway. I never knew you could do this to find the important people. Really convenient. As if I really needed one more thing to... for me to not really look at what's happening on the screen, right? Cool, cool, cool. What the hell were we doing again? Yeah, so that's outside the city. We're not gonna do that just yet. Should be no problem. We fought all those things before. And frankly, I want to fight the stalker again, cause... Ooh, is that where it is? Yeah. What the hell? Why are they so far apart? Oh, can I find like a generic sawtooth and just get that one? I wonder. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to fighting the Stalker again, because we haven't done it all that often. One more. Whoa, they're so far away I can't even see them. Grid.
That must be the spire. It's huge.
The spire. We better find a book talking about what that is. I'm interested.
Can you believe that the Asram live on top of scrap of the old
ones? Kidding me.
They do. Somewhere up north.
Oh! The Asram live off the scrap of the old ones up north? Isn't that the Banuk? Oh.
A lively week.
Ooh. A band of three. What is this? Are we praying for somebody? Oh, Ursa.
The dances and the music.
The Sun Faith. The seven articles of the Sun Faith. Number 1. Over all the world rises and sets the great sun, as is plainly seen. To all plants, animals, machines, and men it gives life, as is plainly seen. They kind of speak like Yoda. Of all the tribes, none have scaled such heights as the Karja, as guided by the sun. Witnessing these things to be true each day, celebrating these things each day, we believe in the sun and its light gladly and without question. Number 2. Only the sun's rightful heir, born of the radiant line that dates back to Ahriman, the founder, is the speaker for the sun. To him, the sun's desires are revealed, and from his lips, its desires are acted upon by men. He shall be known as the Sun King, and his word shall be law. Born of the radiant line. Yeah, so this society is a little bit more typical then. They don't really value women. They have like kings and queens. I don't even know if they have queens. In all things, we accept the sun's judgment. We offer our bared skin to it, so it might burn our sins away. We partake of its renewal. We wear its heat for a time. As our skin bears its flush, its bronzed armor, we are made strong. In the cracking and peeling away of our old selves, we are made anew. You guys are getting skin cancer, that's what's happening. In the sun's light, we shall speak only in truth. We shall strike only in righteousness, and we shall act as we believe the sun so tasks us. When the shadow falls across us, we shall always remember our illumination. We shall not cast blame for ill fortune, we shall endure. In the coldness of the moon, we accept there will be stillness and death and endings until dawn comes once more. We do this because there are two halves of nature, sun and shadow, and to deny one is to deny the whole of things. Like yin and yang. As a twilight time came before us, ending the world of the ancients, so a twilight time shall come again, for this is the cycle of things. Ooh, are you saying our world will end eventually? The buried shadow shall rise up to eclipse the sun's light and usher in great and terrible change. Even knowing this, we are steadfast in our belief and trust the sun will again bring a new dawn, as it did for our founders so long ago. Holy Meridian shall forever be the seat of the Karja, the city of the sun and the spire venerated as the mark of its founding. A sun king, born of the radiant line, shall always sit upon its throne. For without a speaker for the sun, its will is clouded. For either of these to be denied is to invite a twilight time upon us. I wonder how their society was like when the 13th Sun King was still reigning. Because what these people really believe in is the sun god, right? They don't believe the sun king, it's just that the king speaks for the god. And now the speaker, back during the 13th King, the speaker was like, hey guys, let's go kill everybody, do all these bad things. Do they feel not good about that at all? I don't know. Especially because right now, the 14th Sun King is saying things are completely the opposite. So how do citizens really feel about this? Probably some people are mad, some people are happy. Clearly, the Karja are the children of the sun, and preeminence in its gaze, but so too does its light touch upon the barbarian tribes of the north, east, and south. East is me. Yep, barbarian tribe checking in here. It is the speaker for the sun's duty to interpret if the sun's gaze is directed in approval or reproach. Oh, well, there you go. so determined. It is the duty of the Karja to carry out the sun's will, even in places where the sun, where the light, does not reach. They got a lot of teachings here. Is that what their funeral clothing is like?
Be on your way, Nora. May the sun light your way.
These guys don't seem to want to talk to me. Maybe it's a very solemn event right now.
It's what comes of letting women lead.
Have you seen them?
Hello. You are dressed a little bit funny.
You're Nora. I'm the mournful Naman. My apologies that we meet like this.
Like this?
In grief. You hold yours close, like a talisman. Wait, forgive me. You didn't come for reparations? Someone you lost to the Sun Ring?
No. I know about the Red Raids, but the Karja owe me nothing.
I see. Well, I could use the help of a strong-willed outlander. Then I would owe you very much indeed. These people seek to honor their loved, their lost, with their own voices, not mouthing Karja rituals to Karja stone. But there are obstacles. And while Meridian holds its breath for any disturbance, these robes only tie my hands.
What kind of obstacles?
The first pilgrim is an Asaram who seeks to visit the Shrine of Kings on the road to the city. He waits there now, forbidden to enter by an old sun priest who suffer no heathen. This Utaru lost her companion on the edge of the Jewel, at a pool where snap moths gather.
Jewel.
A shrine was built there to ward off the machines, and its effectiveness leaves much to be desired. And the Manuk would paint a mark on the sun's climb. Call to the machine spirits, I understand. They need no beckoning. Glinthawks perch there, drawn to the spire's shining.
So clear the machines out of two shrines and move a priest out of the other.
All I can ask for is your charity and that their stories are heard.
Naman, rituals and prayers can't bring back those who are lost.
No, but it can help those who grieve to find themselves. It can lend them strength and hope, like a new sunrise.
I didn't think your priesthood would ask outsiders for help.
Mm-hmm.
If only the sun would set on our pride. Until this is done, I am no sun priest.
Oh!
To wear a red robe was an aspiration. I aspired. Now our hoods make us blind. We whisper reconciliation, but forget how the old king's priests sang the words and blessed the killing.
The killing? You mean the Red Raids?
Yes. And the sacrifices that came after.
Why did the priests go along with all that bloodshed?
Sometimes we Karja are more concerned with what is tradition than what is right.
Huh. Maybe the Karja and Nora aren't so different.
Whoa, this guy has a very, very advanced view for someone who is in such a traditionally, what do you call that, like a role charged by or motivated by tradition.
You're disappointed with the Sun Priests, but you still wanted to be one?
I spent my whole life looking up to the temple, my brother's voice echoing in its arches. Even he couldn't turn me away, and how he tried, in the end. He said, when we were loved, our robes were dyed in cinnabar. Now they are stained in blood.
How so?
Our robes are handed down to us. Most of the old priests fled rather than be seen in the glare of a new sun. And so we are left to wear their sins. For me, at least, they hang heavy.
Where is your brother now?
Dead?
He waits for me on the trail of the sun, I hope. He spoke out against the sacrifices. For a priest to question the Sun King's will, his punishment was worst of all.
You lost someone you loved, too. I'm sorry.
No, not lost. When I took on these robes, I found his memory.
I'll do what I can to help those in mourning.
To honor their memories is to honor us all.
So these robes, they're not funeral robes. It's the robes of the sun priests. I mean, at the end of the day, Karja people are just very... Is it a camp? Yeah, very fueled by tradition. And the king, no matter what kind of person he turns out to be, as long as he was born in the right family, then his word is absolute. I mean, there's a reason why we moved away from that model, right? But they haven't gotten to that point yet. Well, it seems like there are no more quests here, although I'm pretty sure something is still missing. Probably, if we look around a little bit more, talk to more people. There's plenty of people we haven't talked to yet. Like, where is... Areed? We saw him earlier. Yeah, was that the person that I was supposed to look for? The person affiliated with Nakoa, I think.
Trickery. Deceit. The Shadow Karja know them well, and now they've murdered our Captain Ursa.
The Shadow Karja.
Good to see you.
Is that the name for the bad Karja? Here he is. I'm so lost. This place is huge. Oh, you're a sun priest.
Areed. Didn't want to startle you.
Oh, yes. I heard of the tragedy that befell your tribe. The sun hung low that day as we traveled back.
Ah, no, that's the guy that came to my tribe and the tomatoes and the... Yeah, that guy. Well, then where is Nakoa then? Oh.
So, this is the Temple of the Sun Priests.
Where we offer our daily prayers for balance. I'm afraid only Karja can participate, but you are welcome to observe.
Don't worry, I'm used to it. What are these prayers?
To recognize the sun is to recognize we live in renewal. By its rise and fall, we determine what to take up and what to set aside. Offered to its pure heat, the skin peels, and old time is burned away. We treasure the blisters.
That sounds painful.
Well, there is no glory without sacrifice.
It's hard for us to understand because we live in a cold place.
The temple looks out on the tower across the valley. Why?
Ah, that's the spire, guiding us forever skyward, gleaming with the rays of the sun at noon. It is said that the spire's shadow lay across this mesa when our ancestors came to the valley, searching for a home. Thus, sun and spire joined, showing the Karja where to build. The dawn of Meridian.
I will bet you 20,000 shards that the spire is something related to the cauldrons.
Always illuminating, Areed.
May your tread be as sure as the sun's rising.
Related to all the, you know, the machine stuff at the very, very minimum. Ah, there is a view. It's all black. It wasn't built. The weird thing is, it wasn't built back when Bashar Mati was writing his journals. So it's something new. Newish. Wait, yeah, I still don't know how long... How long has the world been like this? I don't know. I remember reading that one note saying that the old ones were still around back in 2064, but when is it now? I don't think they use that calendar anymore, these tribes, so it's kind of hard to compare the times, the timelines.